Welcome to Landscape Architecture AR171-1P. This is Architect Alan R. Bonaventura, Faculty of the Mapua University Architecture, Interior Design and Built Environment. Landscape architecture is a development and decorative planting of gardens, yards, grounds, parks, and other planned green outdoor spaces. Landscape gardening is used to enhance nature and to create a natural setting for buildings, towns, and cities. It is one of the decorative arts and is allied to architecture, city planning, and horticulture. History of landscape architecture. Egypt introduced advanced method of irrigation, geometric planning, walled cities, and the labyrinth, which later influenced the development of mazes, a popular element in the medieval and Renaissance gardens. Assyria introduced the idea of large hooded hunting parks with small pavilions used for meditation and leisure. Persian gardens were influenced by the walled cities of Egypt, the hunting lands of Assyria, and other gardens in foreign lands. Because water was a precious commodity in these hot and arid locations, it played a central element in the garden, with fountains usually centrally located. The rise of Islam in the 7th century emphasizes that paradise was a garden. Islamic gardens were designed to be looked on from above and to tease all the senses through the incorporation of fragrant plants, color, textures, and water. In Spain, the Moors reintroduced irrigation and water was brought into the landscape in a large quantities as a central focal point. In China, large parks with expansive water features included islands to attract mythical immortals so that people could discover the secret of long life. These imperial gardens could only be implemented by the emperor, while other Chinese gardens were more modest. Japan was heavily influenced by Chinese gardens. Being smaller, however, Japan adopted the major features of Chinese gardens to small-scale Zen gardens. The Zen philosophy influenced the Japanese garden movements with the introduction of features that were symbolic of natural elements. These included carefully placed boulders in screened sand, suggesting island amid a body of water. Greek gardens revolve around a combination of orchard, vineyard, and floral display with a fountain as a focal point. Greek mythology heavily influenced the introduction of sculpture to the garden. Romans were also responsible for the introduction of topiary. After the fall of the Roman Empire, medieval gardens became primarily utilitarian with a heavy focus on food production and medicine. Italian Renaissance gardens were designed with humanistic as opposed to the naturalistic values. Mathematics, geometric patterns, and a strong relationship between the villa and the garden formed the basis of this garden movement. Designers would use changes in elevation and incorporate elaborate water features to create waterfalls and pools. In France, André Le Nôtre, designer of Vaux-le-Vicomte and Versailles, introduced concepts of perspective and scale to visually expand the space. This was achieved by using an increased scale of planting, incorporating parterres of broad terraces, placing sculpture and installing groundwater features. Thomas Jefferson influenced the development of the American landscape. Plant collection was a major interest of Jefferson's and resulted in thousands of newly documented plant species. These plants were then introduced to English plant collectors, and prospering horticultural industry developed in the New World. Jefferson's design in the University of Virginia campus, influenced by his stay in France, affected the design of colleges campuses throughout the United States. Andrew Jackson Downing influenced the establishment of landscape architecture in the United States. He introduced the English concept of romantic or naturalistic style landscape to America and went to the influence other notable designers, including Frederick Law Olmsted, considered by many to be the father of modern landscape architecture in America.